Welcome aboard the virtual ship with Fellowship Chicago. While we can't have church traditionally, we can still be the church consistently. New method, same message. New platform, same power. New season, same God. Now, let's go into our worship experience.
Fellowship family and friends, welcome aboard the virtual ship. We're excited today because this is our Christmas musical. When I tell you this year, the music ministry has been a blessing all year long. Shout out to Elder V, our worship and arts director. Shout out to Brother Willie Jones, our musical director, to the band, to every praise team member, to every choir member, to every administrator worker that has served to help keep the music ministry together. God bless you all. I have been so inspired. I have been refreshed by your ministry this year. And we're excited that during this Christmas season, we're getting ready to celebrate Jesus through music. Indeed, it's Christmas. Christ, we're celebrating Christ being masked into flesh. This is not about Jack Frost. This is not about Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. This is not about getting a sweet kiss under the mistletoe. At the end of the day, it's all about Jesus. Nothing wrong with enjoying this season. I really do hope you do enjoy this season through all the pandemic, through all of the things that make gathering difficult this year. I pray that you can experience through this night some great joy. I pray that tonight you're able to experience what it really means to have a real, genuine, powerful relationship with Jesus Christ. And may his joy, and may his peace, and may his love fill your homes with warmth tonight. Be blessed by the music emanating from the sanctuary of Fellowship Chicago. It's about to be lit. And we're not just talking about lit like the world talks about it, but it's going to be lit for Jesus tonight. He is the center and the main attraction of all that we do during this Christmas musical. So tell a friend, text it, tweet it, press share, press all of the digital buttons that allow you to paste, copy and paste, and send this link out to let somebody know it's about to be a blessing tonight. Enjoy. Cuddle up with your boo or your bae. Cuddle up with your family and enjoy this Christmas musical tonight. I'll see you shortly. Peace, peace.
and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make us know? And this child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Sad to the blind man. Mary, did you know your baby boy calmed the storm with his hands? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels tried? And when you kiss your lips, the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know?
Mary, did you know?
The blind will see, the dead Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? I'm the sleeping child.
What does the birth of Jesus Christ mean to me? That can be summed up with one word, peace. Let's have a look at Luke chapter 2. In Luke chapter 2, we are told the story of the birth of Christ. When Joseph and Mary arrived in Bethlehem to participate in the Roman census, a miracle occurred. Mary gave birth to Jesus. Nearby, a group of shepherds were minding their own business, doing their own thing, when an angel from heaven announced the good news. Their Savior, the Messiah, was born. Then comes the scripture that stands out to me, which encapsulates the meaning of the birth of Jesus. A heavenly host came forth and praised God, saying in Luke chapter 2, verse 14, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." Now let me read that one more time. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests. As followers of Christ, God has favored us. The birth of Jesus ushered in a new era of peace for his chosen people, as Jesus would eventually sacrifice his own life so that we may have life. I am so thankful for this peace that comes with following Jesus. I know that I am covered despite my wrongdoings and that Jesus will always provide a way forward for me. This peace also instills me with, and I believe it should also instill in you, an unwavering sense of optimism that everything will be all right, and that we as the body of Christ will prosper. This has been an unbelievably challenging year with the pandemic, political uncertainty, and social upheaval, but this peace has kept me sane, and I know we are only going up in 2021. Merry Christmas, Fellowship. I love you all.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go, take a look at the 5 and 10. It's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. You see their toys in every store, but the prettiest that will be is the holly that will be on your own front door.
Come on, Anders, let me hear you.
Hi, my name is Michael Eason. I'm the drummer for Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church. I'm here discussing on what the birth of Jesus means to me. According to the book of Matthew, the first chapter, 23rd verse, it talks about Mary having this baby and she's being conceived by the Holy Spirit. And it tells her that she's going to give him a name. And one of the names was Emmanuel, which means God is with us. And when I think of the birth of Jesus, I think that he's with me everywhere I go, everywhere I may be, wherever I'm got going on, he's with me. He's everywhere I go. He's omnipresent at all times. So that's what the birth of Jesus means to me.
You pray it lasts a lifetime. So
it's that time again when we come together. It's that time again where we celebrate one another. Oh,
Christmas to me is all about the birth of Jesus Christ. Philippians 4 and 13 says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. I want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas. Have a good day.
Hang on a mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better. This Christmas, and as we trim the tree, how much fun it's gonna be together. This Christmas, fireside blazing bright, we're caroling through the night. This Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Christmas.
Isaiah 9 and 6 says, "For unto us a child is born, a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder. And what will we call him? Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." Christmas means to me, it's a time to give, love, and rejoice. I rejoice because I know it's December 25th, and if God kept me all year round, year long, from different hurt, harm, different situations, it's time for me to rejoice. It's time for me to love my family, love my friends, to show as much love as I possibly can. And it's a time for me to give unto others that may be less fortunate, or just give to people that just may need or something, just time to give. That's what Christmas means to me.
Ba 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 what it is. Can I tell you how it is? Oh, to know how it feels to be in the presence of a king. Do you know what it is? Take a minute to tell you how it is. Oh, to know how it feels to be in the presence of the King. It's a sweet presence. It's God's presence right where you are. You can experience fullness, the fullness of joy, sweet presence. Let us all be presence. And I'm so honored and I'm privileged to be in the presence of a king. Oh, the fullness of joy, sweet presence, oh, bathing His presence, and I'm so honored. I'm to be in the presence, right here in the presence of the King. It's such an honor. I'm very privileged to be in the presence of the King. Such an honor. And a privilege to be in the presence. I love the cheers. I worship and adore you. From the bottom of my heart, Lord, I knew. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. I want to take this time to tell you from the bottom of my heart, I love you. Oh, 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 oh table. Lord, I just want to take this time, take this time, take this time, take this time, Lord. Lord, I love you. Nobody but you, Lord, kept me all this time, Lord. Right where you are, just lift your hands and say, Lord, I love you. I wanna take this time to tell you, Lord, Lord, I love you. More than any gift, more than any surprises. Lord, we love you. Lord, we honor you. Everything you've done for us, Lord, we love you, we love you. We want to just take a moment, tell you how we feel from our heart, Lord. Oh, you've been so good to us, watched over us all year long. Oh, no goodness of our own, Lord.
Matthew 2:11 says, and as they were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshiped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Matthew 25:40 states, verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of these, my brethren, ye have done it unto me. As you think about these two scriptures, can you imagine God being in heaven on his perfect throne, then making the decision to wrap himself in humanity? And as he wrapped himself in humanity, Jesus was born on this earth in the most humble way possible. He didn't come into this world bursting through the clouds on a high throne. He came as one of the lowest of people. When I think about the birth of Christ, I think about the less fortunate and how Jesus came as one who was less fortunate. He was born on the street. Think about that. But in turn, he actually added so much value to the entire world. This means that you don't have to be a millionaire or a highly educated person to add value to someone else's life. For all you have to do is love and spread love. For me, this is a reminder that even I can add value and so can you. When I think about what the birth of Christ means to me, I think about how I can add value to my community, to my friends, coworkers, and family. You don't know what a simple hug could mean to someone else right now. Many of us live in houses with at least 3 or 4 bathrooms, with jacuzzis and California king-size beds, and TVs in every room. But Jesus didn't have a place to lay his head. And that scripture reminds us that what we do unto the least of these, we do ultimately to God. So as you remember Christ's birthday, ask yourself, how can I add value to all those around me?
Your feet.
family, I pray you've been blessed tonight again. Jesus is the reason for this season. And I pray that you would not be caught up with all of the gifts that may not be under your tree, but think about the gift that died on a tree for all of us so that we can have access to abundant life and eternal life. If you don't know Jesus Christ today, we want to offer him to you. The information is right there on the screen. Isn't it amazing that even at a musical, somebody could be saved tonight? A, admit that you're a sinner. B, believe that Jesus Christ died for your sins and you believe that he rose from the dead. And C, confess him with your mouth that he is Lord. It's as simple as ABC. If you've prayed that prayer, repeated that prayer, or thought that what I said is something that you really do believe and want to say for yourself, we believe that today you've been saved. So we want you to text us. We want you to email us. We want you to connect with us. Do whatever you have to do. Email, text is fine. But the main point is that you don't leave this Christmas season missing the Christ in Christmas. Thank you. Shout out to the music ministry. Come on, help me give them a hand for all of the work that they've done, all of the singing, all of the testimonials, the band. Just the thoughtfulness and the intentionality behind everything that's been done tonight. It has glorified God, and it has simply made our hearts glad that we walk with this Savior who is called the Christ. At this time, we don't want to conclude without giving you an opportunity to give. I know that you've purchased and bought Christmas gifts for everybody else, but I want to challenge you to bring a gift tonight to the main King of Kings in the spirit of the three wise men. We want to bring gifts. They brought gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Gold symbolizing Jesus' royalty because he is the King of Kings. Frankincense, representative of Jesus' divinity. It was an incense that was burned during worship. And then myrrh. It was an embalming fluid. It represents Calvary. So the gifts that they brought to Jesus as a baby represented the totality of all that he would be. He is royal. He is the King of Kings. He's worthy of our worship in his divinity. And he did die for all of our sins. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Well, tonight we don't have those items, but we do have $50 bills, $20 bills, $10 bills, $5 bills. We do have PayPal, Cash App, Zelle, Shelby Next Giving, and I want you to join me in sowing a seed tonight to bless the God that sent his only begotten son so that we could be saved. Would you join me tonight in sowing a seed of $25 just to say, I'm not putting anybody before I put Jesus first this year. Join me in sowing a seed of $25 for this Christmas season. Let's sow into God's house. And I promise, whatever you give for God, it comes back tenfold, 100-fold. Only God can do that. Let's pray. God, I thank you for tonight. Would you sanctify this night? Would you bless every gift and giver? I pray that nobody lack because of what they sow tonight. And then, God, for the person that's having a strange Christmas, a lonely Christmas, an unusual Christmas, would you give them the ability to still feel your peace, to still feel your love and your joy in this season? And regardless, if we didn't get to travel like we wanted to and eat what we wanted to eat and see all the people we wanted to see, God, I pray that you would fill our lives with great joy. Make our time with our family and friends meaningful and safe. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Let everybody say amen, amen, and amen. Music ministry, y'all are one of a kind. I love you so much. You've blessed my life tonight, and you've blessed thousands of others. It is my prayer, as always, may your struggles keep you near the cross. May your troubles show that you need God. May your battles end the way they should, and may your bad days prove that God is good. May your whole life prove that God is good. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. Merry Christmas from Fellowship Chicago. We love you. Peace, peace.
Thank you for worshiping with Fellowship Chicago on the virtual ship. We've always had a commitment of service, and during this season, we've increased our efforts to serve you better. We have made it easy for you to stay connected to get the complete resources you need. You can email us at info@fellowshipchicago.com. Call the church office Tuesday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. at 773-924-3232. And our social media on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. For real-time updates, you can text Fellowship Chicago to 31996. We have exciting and informative resources throughout the entire week designed specifically with you in mind. Go to fellowshipchicago.com for the full schedule. Until we dock again, thank you for your prayers and financial support of Fellowship Chicago. Remember, we are in this together.